like crazy, right? So
I take it.
Outbidding each other, the city of Evansville was built, right? And they decided that they wanted to bring commerce here. They also had a brownfield because this place was a toxic dump. And all of the toxins were going out to the bay. And so they had this money, and I'm coming
yeah.
The problem is that they knew that this was a shell mound. It was over 60 feet high. So imagine the tallest building here, 350 feet diameter. So we're talking about 3.5 football fields, right? Huge amount of property. This was a landmark for our ancestors. It was so huge that it was on 1867 post-survey map. So people coming in the bay would see this huge mound and use it as a point of reference to get here. UC Berkeley was the first place to desecrate this area. UC Berkeley started its archaeology department by destroying the shell mound. Right? So thousands of our ancestors were taken out of here, and they still sit at UC Berkeley in lockers. My nephews and my nieces that are here, we actually went there on Indigenous Peoples Day. And after all these years, we're praying for our ancestors to come home. We're praying for them to come out of UC Berkeley. We actually got to see them for the very first time. It was horrible, horrible. It was worse than I could even imagine. And it really broke me down. What it was telling me is that the ancestors really want the work to continue and that we need to do something. Carmela and I are working now to create a land trust in the Bay Area, the first native land trust in an urban area. And so one of the things that we're trying to do after all of this work of walking, we're talking about Shellmound walkers. Starting at Segorite, walking down to San Jose, up the other side, and ending here the day after Thanksgiving. Every year, for 4 years. And we were joined by these Buddhist monks and nuns who walked with us, and we said prayers. And we stopped at these shell mounds, and these shell mounds were under